I'm coming back to the start, where you found me. I'm coming back to your heart. I surrender. Take me. This is all I can bring.
You ready?
Church, hallelujah. You're all welcome to our online service. Join us as we praise and glorify the King of Kings, and as we listen to the word of God from the man of God. Be blessed.
Oh,
Jesus. You deserve all our worship. You deserve all our dances, King of Glory. You deserve all our music, King of Glory, Jesus. You are glorious, Lord. You are mighty. Receive all that glory. Receive all the honor, King of Glory. We commit ourselves to you as we worship and exalt your holy name. Thank you, King of Glory. Thank you, Jesus. You are mighty. You are glorious.
We praise and glorify your holy name, Jesus. We worship you in this place. We give you all the praise. You deserve all the honor. You deserve all the glory. There is none like you, Lord. There is none that compares to you. You're the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. Lord, you exist in time. You are before time. You are after time. And Lord, that's why we worship you. Lord, you're so good. And we just join with our angels to sing holy, holy, and magnificent and glorious is your name. You deserve the glory and the honor. Lord, we lift our hands towards as we glorify your name. You deserve the glory and the honor. Lord, we lift our hands to worship as we glorify your name.
Miracles so great. There is no one else like you. thank you very much, choir, for the work well done. We praise God for your availability, for the time that you have given in to make sure this worship is as good as it is. And we also want to thank God for the media team, for the work they have done. Let's clap for the choir and for the media team. They have done a very good work, and we want to celebrate God for them. That is wonderful. And we want also to appreciate you members for not missing the service, even during this season when we have been down. All of you have been attending the service. Thank you very much for the work well done and for the way you have been responding towards the messages, the sacrificial thing, and even the way you are subscribing over the YouTube. Thank you very much for what you are doing. We also want to ask you to share this message with other friends that you have. I am very grateful for the friends who have been sending to their friends outside Uganda. They have been benefiting out of this, and we are grateful for whatsoever God has used you to do. We want to build this system to be a bigger one. We are helping us having a studio where we are fully fledged, and we can, why not a TV station? We should also pray during this season and ask God for bigger things like a TV station. Let's pray. Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace, the joy of our salvation, the one who is now speaking to us through his Son. Those days you would appear to us through the angels, but nowadays you have loved us, you've made us your friends, and you can now speak to us as your friends. We are giving you glory for whatever you have done. At such a time when we are meeting in these families, sharing your word, may your voice be strong and speak to us. We give you glory and honor in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, we had started our series. This is our second one, on understanding the power of thanksgiving. Understanding the power of thanksgiving. This is our second series, and we shall be pushing it to the fourth series. So we want again to appreciate you that God has given us opportunity to meet together. One of the favorite books that I've enjoyed of late is the book of Philemon. The book of Philemon introduces Onesimus as a brother instead of introducing him as a slave. That's what the Bible says, that we are no longer slaves, but we are the friends of God. So what God has done for us is to make sure he transfers us from the position of being servants, being slaves, into being the children of God. And that's the major thing that we should keep telling God, thank you. You have picked me and changed my title and my position into a child of God. Not just a child. The Bible says that Jesus was given to us as a child. But also, God gave to him, he was born to us as a child, but God gave to him to us as a son. When he introduced him as his beloved son. And so that's one of the things that we can tell God thank you about. We thank God for that one. Today I want us to look at this second bit of understanding the power of of thanksgiving in an interesting way. One thing that I want you to know is that instructions are the highway to high places. Instructions are a highway to high places in life. And you can never achieve much if you can fail to abide by instructions. When you are in right standing with God, He raises up on our behalf. God decides to raise up on our behalf because we understand the instructions. The Lord is my shepherd, so we look at God as our shepherd. We are also instructed to look at God as our salvation and our light. And so understanding those instructions will help you to keep in line and with the relationship with your God. When God comes down, every opposition is leveled. When God comes down, every opposition is leveled. The scripture says in the book of Psalms, Psalm 22 verse 3, Psalm 23 verse 3, it says, "You are holy. You sit as king, receiving praises of Israel." God is holy, and he sits as a king, receiving praises of Israel. "Tremble, O earth, before the Lord, before the God of Jacob. Tremble, O earth, before the Lord, before the God of Jacob." Psalm 114, verse 7, is instructing us to tremble. It is an instruction. We tremble before the Lord and the God of Jacob. Praise and thanksgiving are vital to God. When God hears praise from your mouth, even what you don't ask for, he gives you. When he hears praise from your mouth, even when whatsoever you have not asked for, because you are able to tell him thank you, so he is able to give even what you have not asked for. One sure way to maintain the favor of God is to engage in a habitual thanksgiving. You are building relationship closer. You are maintaining the favor of God through engaging the habitual way of telling God thank you. In the book of Acts chapter 16 verse 22 downwards, the scripture says the crowd joined the attack against them, and the magistrates tore the clothes of Paul and Silas and ordered them to be beaten by rods. After they had been beaten them severely, they threw them into prison and commanded the jailer to guard them securely. Receiving such orders, he threw them in the inner cell and fastened their feet in the stocks. About midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and that the rest of the prisoners and the rest of the prisoners were listening to them. I think they were singing like this: Katonda tumwebaze olwechisa chechinji kaletwe bali. When they were singing like that, the scripture says suddenly a great earthquake occurred, so that the foundations of the prison were shaken. Immediately all the doors flew open and the bonds of all the prisoners came loose. When the jailers woke up and saw the doors of the prisoners standing open, he threw his sword and was about to kill himself because he assumed the prisoners had escaped. But Paul called out loudly, "Don't harm yourself, sir, for we are all here." Calling to the lights, the jailer rushed in and fell down trembling at the feet of Paul and Silas. Then he brought them outside and asked them, "Sirs, what must I do to be saved?" They replied, "Believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, you will be saved, you and your household." And he met with the people and appointed musicians. Okay, what I wanted to show you there in the book of Acts is the way Paul and Silas had a relationship that caused them to have God listen to them at midnight. Instead of looking at the challenge they were going through, they started praising God. Many times, whenever we are going through situations, we begin blaming people. We begin even allocating blames. We can blame our parents. We can blame our husbands. We can blame our wives. We can blame whosoever comes first to be blamed. But Paul did not look at what the jailers have done, at what the magistrate did, even when they were beaten without any cause. They looked to God and said, "God, we have never seen any other thing, but we want to worship and recognize you. We want to give you thanks." And the scripture says, while they were still worshiping, while they were still praising God, the earthquake started. you can cause God to release earthquake on your behalf because God wants you out of prison. The second book of Chronicles, chapter 20, verse 21. Second Chronicles, chapter 20, verse 21. The scripture says, he met with the people and appointed musicians to play before the Lord and praise his majestic splendor as they marched ahead of the warriors and said, give thanks to the Lord, for his love endures forever. When they began to shout and praise, the Lord suddenly attacked the Ammonites and the Moabites. Lord suddenly attacked the Moabites and the Ammonites and men from Mount Seir who were invading Judah, and they were defeated. The Ammonites and the Moabites attacked the men of Mount Seir and annihilated them. When they had finished all the men of Seir, they attacked and destroyed one another. That is how thanksgiving can cause God to come in your way. Many times we forget thanksgiving and we begin praying hard. Okay, praying hard is a good thing, but there is a way you should learn how to go to this other level of engaging God to tell him, thank you for what you are, thank you for what you have done for me, thank you for the life. I hope last week you went through the teaching, and when you went through the teaching, I had told you that action number one, let us sit down and begin looking at the things that God has done for us. And I pray that you remember to thank God. And as we continue, I will expect you, even during next week, when we shall be having prayer and fasting for 3 days, take a full day of telling God, thank you for what you have done. Luke chapter 17, verse 12 to 17. Luke chapter 17, verse 12 to 17. In the season of praise, anything can happen. Laws, regulations, and decisions can change. When you thank God and you learn to engage him in thanksgiving, there are some laws that can change. There are some regulations that and decisions that can change. Future testimonies are brought to us in thanksgiving. You tell God, thank you for now, but also thank you for my future. He knows the future. God brings forth into the now for us testimonies that were meant for the future. He is able to do something that can be reversed for you on your behalf. Let me tell you, recently we had gone to Kampala during the time when we were going to have our children back. And of course, the law states that we should have fewer people in the car, and so the car that we had could not carry all of us. And when we reached somewhere, I was able to get out of the car, and I stopped somewhere. For some time, there were so many children poured on the road because they are going home and they don't have transport at a time of lockdown. So what I did was to tell God, thank you, but I want to find out, God, are you only God, the God of the earth and heaven, and you are not the God of the vehicles? I am asking you, Lord, that you give me a car now and you take me home. It was very interesting. When I started giving thanks, thank you, God, for the car. Thank you, God, for the car. Thank you, God, for the car. While I was saying like that, suddenly there appeared a brother who said, is this Pastor Silva? I said, yes, I am. Where are you going? I am going to Mukono. Instead of saying I'm going to Mbale, I am going to Mukono. He said, okay, I can take you to Mukono. When you reached Mukono, he said, okay, me, I am proceeding. I will be going to Kakira. I said, you take me to Kakira. When you reached Kakira, he said, wow, is it okay for us to proceed to Mbale? I said, oh yes, take me to Mbale. That's how you can engage God and allow him to do his part when you are giving thanksgiving. In the book of Luke, chapter 17, verse 20, 12 to 20 to 17, Luke chapter 17, verse 12 to 17 says, and he was entering a village, and he was entering a village, ten men with leprosy met him. They stood at a distance, raised their voices, and said, Lord Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. When he saw them, he said, go, show yourselves to the priest, and they went along. As they went along, they were cleansed. Verse 15. Then one of them, when he saw He had been healed, turned back, praising God aloud in a loud voice. He fell with his face at the ground at Jesus' feet and thanked him. Now, he was a Samaritan. And Jesus said, "Were not 10 cleansed? Where are the other 9? I am thinking that he's asking a question. Were they not 10? Why is it that only one has come to give thanks? Many times, brethren, we are very good at giving a testimony of what God is doing, but we forget that God, after doing something, he wants us to go back to him and tell him, thank you. If you can't thank God for small things, how do you expect big things to come? When we learn to thank God for the smaller blessings that he gives us, he ensures it does not finish. Our thanksgiving triggers further blessing from God. Our thanksgiving triggers further blessings from God. Thanksgiving is critical to the fulfillment of our destinies. In the book of John, chapter 6, verse 1 to 11. John chapter 6, verse 1 to 11. After this, Jesus went out away to the other side of the Sea of Galilee, also called Sea of Tiberias. A large crowd was following him because they were observing the miraculous signs that he was performing on the sick. So Jesus went up the mountain and sat down there with his disciples. Now, the Jewish feast of the Passover was near. Then Jesus, when he looked up and saw that the large crowd was coming to him, said to Philip, "Where can we buy bread so that these people may eat?" Now Jesus said this to test him, for he knew what he was going to do. Philip replied, 200 silver coins worth of bread would not be enough for them, for each one to get a little. One of Jesus' disciples, Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, said to him, "Here is a boy who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish, but what good are these for many people?" Jesus said, "Have them sit down." Now, there was a lot of grass in that place. So the men sat down, about 5,000 in number. Then Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, I want us to read that again. Then Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, he distributed the bread to those who were seated. He then did the same with the fish, and as much as they wanted. Whatever we give thanks for, God multiplies. What God does for a thanksgiver cannot be hidden. They are public testimonies. We thank God for his faithfulness. The scripture says in the book of Psalm 92, verse 1, a song of the Sabbath day, "It is fitting to thank the Lord and to sing praises to your name, O Sovereign One." It is fitting to thank the Lord and to sing praises to his name, O Sovereign Ones. God gives victories on a daily basis. We have no idea of the battles God continually fights for us. It is the faithfulness of God that keeps us and sustains our blessings. When we praise him, our treasures are turned into testimonies. 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 22. 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 22. When they began to shout and praise the Lord, suddenly God attacked the Ammonites, the Moabites, and men from Mount Seir who were invading Judah, and they were defeated. Instead of bothering yourself about the issues around you, recall to God his faithfulness. Thank him For it and God will step in the battle. We need to learn how to thank God for the battles. We need to thank God for the opportunities that we face during the seasons when we are faced with battle. Our God is a God of war. Psalm 30 verse 7 says, Oh God, in your good favor, you made me secure. Then you rejected me, and I was terrified. God, in his good favor, makes us secure. Learning how to tell him thank you is bringing him closer into your situation. In Jeremiah chapter 30 verse 19, the scripture says, out of those places, you will hear songs of thanksgiving and the sounds of laughter and the merriment. I will increase their number, and they will not dwindle away. I will bring them honor, and they will no longer be diminished. I will increase their number. But he has said that out of those places, you will hear songs of thanksgiving. We need to give God songs of thanksgiving because of what he does daily. God has many things he does, but why he does them is so that we can honor him and tell him thank you. In everyone's life, there will be a time you will see your inabilities, but you must bring them to God in order to gain victory over them. If you take thanksgiving to heart, you will not need to sweat before you see victories. When you continue understanding God, you will continue recognizing him. When you continue recognizing him in the things that he does, you will continue telling him thank you. Learning how to say thank you is something that we need to bring on a daily basis. As we continue in this series, the scripture tells us that we should learn how to tell God thank you. We need to learn to tell God thank you because he has a plan with your life. He has a plan with your life. We want to continue in our series, and I will be very happy to see you in the third series next week. God bless you.
Back to the start where you found me. I'm coming back to your heart. I surrender. Take me. This is all.